Hello friends, welcome to the another lecture of amplitude modulation. In my previous video, I was discussing about the amplitude modulation, its demodulation and based on numerical also. In this video, I am going to discuss the second type of amplitude modulation, which is double sideband suppressed carrier. As you know that, the general expression of amplitude modulation is CT plus MT K CT, where CT is our carrier signal, MT is our message signal, and K is amplitude sensitivity of the amplitude modulator. In the same way, the general expression of double sideband suppressed carrier S of DSBT is MT into CT. That's it. In this expression, as the extra carrier signal is not included, the expression of DSBT is only CT MT, right? Let's draw the spectrum analysis of this. As our message signal MT is like this, minus omega, omega, zero, f or omega. This is our message signal. So, the spectrum analysis of DSBT is like this. This is minus FC, this is FC, this is FC plus omega, this is minus FC minus omega, minus FC minus omega, minus FC plus omega. As you notice, in this figure, no extra carrier is present, only sideband is there. So, the power is saved as compared to the AM modulator. When we calculate bandwidth of this, bandwidth can be defined as the highest positive frequency minus lowest positive frequency. Highest positive frequency is what? FC plus omega. Minus lowest FC minus omega. FC and minus minus plus. FC to FC cancel. That is 2 omega. The bandwidth is same as AM, okay? The bandwidth of amplitude modulation is also 2 omega and the bandwidth of DSBSC is also 2 omega. So, it uses the same channel bandwidth but it require less power because the carrier is missing and here carrier is present. The next topic is single tone AM. Not AM, single tone DSB. The general expression of DSB is MT into CT. One important thing is, due to this MT into CT, it can also be called as product modulator. Product modulator. Because here the two product is there, MT and CT. In single tone DSB analysis, let us consider our message signal MT is AC cos 2 pi FCT. So DSB SC is AC cos 2 pi FCT and our carrier frequency is what? AC cos 2 pi FCT this is our carrier and our message signal is, sorry, little mistake is there. FC is not FM because message signal is used. So we use FM, and in place of carrier we use FC. So MT into CT. CT is this into MT. MT is what? AM cos 2 pi FMT. Here cos A, cos B. Use simple formula. After we use that, we get AC AM by 2 cos FC plus FMT plus AC AM by 2 cos FC minus FMT. This is the general expression of single tone AM, where FC plus FM is USB, FC minus FM is LSB. What is USB and LSB? I told in my previous video. Fine. When we calculate the power, total power presented in amplitude modulation, then power is total power present in LSB plus total power present in USB. This is AC square AM square by 8 plus AC square AM square by 8. Then total power AC square AM square by 4. This is the total power of DSB SC modulator. When we talk about efficiency, efficiency is P sideband upon PT. You know it very well. In DSB SC, the sideband power equals to total power because there is no carrier power is present. Carrier signal is not present. Then efficiency is 1, that is 100%. Means power is saved and the total power is, the expression of total power is this. The next point is multi-tone DSB. MT into CT in multi-tone AM1 cos 2 pi FM1T plus AM2 cos 2 pi FM2T. And all the analysis is follow as same as S of AMT. Put this equation into this and multiply with the carrier signal and you will get the desired expression. I was solved in my previous video. You can check out that video in which I solve the multi-tone modulation of AMT, right? Now our next point is how it can be modulated and it can be demodulated. We'll see first how it can be modulated. There are two methods to modulate this signal or to produce this signal. First is product modulator. And the another one is ring modulator. In both ways, you can generate this DSB SC signal. So first is product modulator. Product modulator is also called balance modulator. Means balance modulator and product both are same. In this method, first is AM modulator. Two AM modulator is used to produce DSB SC signal. This is first, this is one second. let me draw the diagram first. This is the architecture of a balance modulator, in which there are two amplitude modulators are connected, AM modulator 1 and AM modulator 2, with the phase degree, phase shift of 180 degree. Means here S dash of AMT and here S double dash of AMT and S of DSBT is S dash of AMT minus S double dash of AMT, right? And carrier is need, you know it very well, to produce our AM signal. So what is S dash of AM and S double dash of AM? S of AM is nothing but an amplitude signal. So S dash of AMT 1 AC 1 plus KMT cos 2 pi FCT, and S double dash of AMT is AC 1 minus KMT cos 2 pi FCT. From where minus is come? Due to 180 degree phase shift. This is also called as Hilbert transform. Due to that phase shift, here minus sign is there. S of DS3SC is S dash of AMT minus S double dash of AMT. So equation number 1 minus with equation number 2. AC plus AC KMT cos 2 pi FCT minus AC and minus minus plus AC KMT cos 2 pi FCT. AC to AC cancel, AC KMT cos 2 pi FCT, AC KMT cos 2 pi FCT means 2 AC KMT cos 2 pi FCT. Let 2K AC is AC dash. Okay. Then final 2K AC is AC dash. AC dash MT cos 2 pi FCT. This is our desired DSB signal. Fine. In which one carrier is there and one message signal is there. All set. The another method is ring modulator. In ring modulator, we use diode to produce message, DSB-SC signal. The four diode is connected in this way. Like this. This is our CT, this is our MT, and this is our S of DSBT. We can say that diode D1, D2, D3, D4. Fine. Now we discuss about some analog concept. When CT is positive and when CT is negative. When CT is positive, diode D1 and D2 is forward bias and D3, D4 is
reverse bias. When D1 and D2 is forward bias, means it is a short circuit and this one become an open circuit. When when CT is negative, D1 and D2 is reverse bias, this one become forward bias. Means when CT is positive, then output is plus empty, and when CT is negative, then output is minus empty. Let me explain with graph also. Suppose this is empty . This is CT, and S of DSVT is what? Empty into CT. When CT is positive, then output is what? Empty. Like this, and after that it will become like this. When CT is negative, output is minus empty, like this, and when CT is positive, output become empty, but empty is like this, downside, so it will show like this, and after that it follow the same rule. So this is our desire S of DSVT. If you have any doubt, then do comment in the comment section. Due to this empty into CT, it is also called product modulator. We can modulate DSB SC in two ways. First is balance modulator, and another one is ring modulator. Fine, clear too. And now the next topic is demodulation of DSB SC. The demodulation of DSB-SC is possible only one way, with only one way, and this is synchronous detector. So as compared to AM modulation, the bandwidth is same, but the power is saved in DSB-SC. But the demodulation of DSB-SC is quite difficult due to the synchronous detector, and the demodulation of AM signal is very easy. So that is the advantage of AM signal over DSB-SC, right? And what is synchronous detector, how it is used, I discussed in my previous video. So for that you can see my previous video also. So that's it for DSB-SC concept. The advantage of DSB-SC is some power is saved. Only power is saved as compared to AM, and bandwidth, when we talk about the bandwidth, then AM bandwidth and DSB bandwidth both are same. And the demodulation is complex in DSB-SC. Demodulation is very simple in AM modulator. And modulation is simple. You can see both the two methods of amplitude modulation. So that's it for DSB-SC modulation. In my next video, I'll discuss SSB. This is the single sideband suppressed carrier. Then the whole chapter of amplitude modulation is complete, and we proceed to our next chapter, frequency modulation and phase modulation too. Okay, so thanks for watching this video. Thank you.